I am Paul Cha. I'm capable of progressing the University of Science and Technology. In this presentation, I'd like to cover the issue of capturing context-sensitive information for image retrieval. In this paper, for effective image retrieval, we propose a new non-linear simulated model, a new simulated method, and a new simulated ranking algorithm. In our method yields encouraging experiment results for real image database. This is the first motivated example. The first image is the previous US President Barack Obama. If the human can recognize that the second and the third images are also the Barack Obama, but the computer cannot understand the second and the third image is the same person who is the Barack Obama. If we use a standard similarity measure, for example, Euclidean distance, the original image and the precursors, the figure B and C, may not exhibit their similarity, even if human can catch it. This is the second motivating example. In figure 2, there are two groups of car images, and the images in each group are similar to each other. In actual simulated search, however, images in other groups may be selected as the similar ones to the query image. For example, the image D1, may be selected as the similar one to the query image C2 instead of the image D2 when the conventional simulated definition is used. This is the simulated search. The typical example is I would like to find the most I would like to find the movie star most similar to me. Do you understand? That is the typical example. When the smartphone appears first, there is an app. I submit my image, my picture, and the app returns the most similar movie star to me. Also, this is a third motivating example. This is the handwritten digit image made by primary school children. In figures, this figure, D2, I submit the sample image and I would like to find the most similar images to the query image. For example, D2 may be selected as the similar one to the query image D1. D1 is the query image. The digit number is 4, but the computer think that D2 is similar to D1, but human think that these are different digit, but computer think that D2 is similar to D1. This is the semantic gap between a person and the computer. This is the first motivated example. With this figure 4, I explain the objective of our work more concretely. There are two data clusters, two groups of data. The old data in real world is represented by a single point. Single point. So this single point is the data object. All data objects is represented by a single point. There are two groups of data. We insist that the point this is point one. When you see this figure, point two is nearer to point one compared to point three. But we insist that point one is nearer to point three in the same class as in the same group than point two in the other class, even if point two is nearer to point one than point three in Euclidean distance. We would like to insist that point three is similar to point one compared to point two, because point three is in the same group in point one. But it is very difficult. It is very difficult to find the point one and the point three are included in the same group. Based on this concept, we define the semantics of the image data set as the contextual relationship in the data set. In other words, the information about the distribution and the cluster structure. Cluster means a group of a given data set. We attempt to tackle the semantic gap problem in image search by capturing the nonlinear relationships in contextual information given by an image collection. The equation is a Gaussian function. We adopt a Gaussian function as basic similarity model. In the equation, xi and xj is two data objects. In this equation, Gaussian function g means the similarity function between data object xi and xj. The Gaussian function possesses an excellent nonlinear approximation capability. The exponential function in Gaussian equation is more sensitive to local changes and give rise to better performance improvement with respect to human perception. So in our model, we transform all data objects in the Gaussian data space. These are the actual example of our transformation using some sample data set. In the figure, we see that there are three groups of data, first, second, third. In this original data set, it is very difficult to separate it is very difficult to separate this data into three groups. So we use the Gaussian transformation. The original data set are transformed into this third group. Then in this original data group, it is very difficult to separate the original data into three groups. But after we transform the original data into this type, it is very simple to separate the data into three groups. This is the second image, second data space. In this original data set, it is very difficult to separate two groups, but after we transform the original data with the Gaussian transformation, these two original data was we can simply separate to these two groups. This data set was transformed into this group, and this data set was transformed into this data set. So it is very simple to separate the original data. This is the key point in my work. This is the ranking algorithm. This ranking algorithm is somewhat similar to Google's PageRank algorithm. There are m data points x1 from x1 to xm, and the data are n-dimensional. Data are in n-dimensional data space. We transform the data to the point on eigenvector pitch space using the spectral cluster algorithm. In step one, we construct the matrix X, matrix K, composed of the object to object similarity. This matrix Kij has the similarity value between all points xi and xj. We construct the diagonal matrix D. All D diagonal matrix D is composed by like this, and we normalize the original K using this equation. From step two, from step two to from step five, from step two to step five provides a suitable normalization necessary for our similar ranking. I will skip the detailed algorithm. This is the result of our experiment. All points are data objects in the real world. The query point is represented by plus sign. Then I compute the similarity between the query object plus and all objects, and you can see this the number beside the point is the rank, rank based on the similarity to the query object. Surprisingly, it is very exact result. This is the most similar object to this object. One first, second, third, fourth. Oh, as you can see, we are surprised. The result is very exact. This result is very good result. But we find that the previous ranking algorithm works well in low-dimensional data space. However, it has limited success on real high-dimensional image data set in our experiments. Therefore, we propose another ranking algorithm for high-dimensional data set based on similarity distribution and a new similarity measure. Also, the data M data object we would like to rank. There is a query point xq. We define the we define the vector x, vector s. Vector s means that the similarity between query objects and all data objects in data set. It means that this is the similarity between object xi and the xq. Xq means the query object. This is the similarity value between data object xi and x1. This is the similarity value between data object xi and x2. And this is final similarity between data object xi and xn. We also define the vector sq. Sq is the similarity value between the query point and all data object in the data set. We define the similarity value xi and xq by the dot product of two similarity vectors for xi and xq in Gaussian feature space. This is the this is the similarity value between data object xi and xq. It means that the similarity is defined by individual similarity between xi and xq plus linear combination of the similarity between xi and xi's neighbors weighted by the similarity xi's neighbors and xq. This means that the similarity of a point affects its neighbor similarity value. Also, it means that if two points are close, they are more influenced by each other because their respective similarity values to query point are weighted by the similarity value between two points. Also, this is the ranking algorithm based on similarity distribution. This is the our experimental results using some synthetic data set. The query point is represented by x and the plus. We would like to find the most similar object to the query points x and plus. Surprisingly, this is very very exact result. As you can see, the number beside the point is the length, similarity length. The first. This is the first. Where is second? Second. Third. Where is third? Third. Fourth. Fifth. As you can see, the query result is very exact in this experiment. This is another experiment result. This is the query object. This is query object. We use MNIST database. MNIST database has 6,000 handwritten digit images written by elementary school children. We would like to find the most similar image to this digit. This is the first most similar image. The second, third, top 100 images by our measure, where the top left image is the query image. This is the experiment result based on the conventional Euclidean distance based in ranking. Then, as you can see, there are images not nine, seven, seven. Four, seven. But in our lizard only one image, not nine. So it means that our experimental lizard is superior to the conventional ranking algorithm. This is also another example. We use the two images. We use the two images as the query image, and also we would like to find the 100 images most similar to the query image. The first is the expected result by our algorithm. And this result is the ranking algorithm based on the conventional Euclidean distance space, Euclidean distance metric. As you can see, there are not four. The image not four. For example, 1, 1, 9, 1, 9. So this experiment is to show that our algorithm is superior to the conventional algorithm. This is also the performance experiment. This graph shows the accuracy on accuracy. Then this is our algorithm. This is the Euclidean based algorithm. This is the algorithm based on SVM. SVM means support vector machine. This graph shows that the accuracy of our algorithm is very good. We also use the frequency and multi-point query accuracy. This graph also shows that our algorithm is superior to other competitors. This is my conclusion. We proposed a new similarity measure and the ranking algorithm based on nonlinear Schmidt model for effective image retrieval. We believe that this kind of nonlinear Schmidt model improves the retrieval effectiveness. The future work, actually, the value of delta sigma in Gaussian function has a great impact on the ranking result. In future work, we are attempting to determine the nearly optimal value of delta. Actually, it's very difficult to the optimal value of delta. In our experiment, we used the experimental value of we used delta value made by many experiments. This is all of my presentation. Yeah, thank you.